sit in the hero pose. Keep your toes together and keep your knees apart. And from that, relax your shoulders back and down. Inhale through your nose, sigh out through your mouth. Let go all the tension from the entire day, the tension from the weekend, the tension from the work, all from whatsoever that no longer serves you. Out and away with your exhaling. Then from here, keep the tip of your finger that touching the mat. And slowly you're gonna nod your head side to side as you lower your left ear close to your left shoulder. Feel the stretch at the left, the right side of your neck. Inhale and exhale, right ear close to the right shoulder, feel the stretch at the left side of your neck. Do this for the next four deep breaths. One more time here. Then you back to the center. Inhale, face up, chin up. Exhale, chin to chest, face down. Inhale and exhale. Do this for the next four deep breaths. Inhale to your nose, and when you exhale, whether to your nose or to your mouth, keep exhaling longer than inhaling. And back to the center, and from here we're gonna circle the neck. So you're gonna rotate from root of the neck. Right ear close to the right shoulder, then chin to chest. Then left ear close to left shoulder, chin up, face up. Do it slowly as you're breathing slowly. Clockwise, three rounds. Anti-clockwise, another three rounds.
Can I only do half? Because I feel they're getting busy.
Sure. So sometimes that people, if they go with the full circle, they might not feel comfortable, right? So you can go only halfway, like chin to chest, and then right ear to the shoulder, chin to chest, left ear to the left shoulder. And after you finish like 6 to 8 times approximately, then you back to the center. Rest your hands on your thigh. Turn your palms facing up. Let go the weight of your arms down to the ground. Let go your entire body weight down. However, being alert, relaxing, while you still relax your body, you're also still being alert. Know what you are doing and know how you feel. And before we start our session, we're gonna make the sound of Om. So make the Om sound in your exhale as long as you can. Allow the Om sound to be longer and louder. Take a deep breath. Om. here, direct to all four. So when you bend all four, keep your shoulders over your hands, right? Keep your hips over the knee. And slowly from here, you're going to keep your left leg back. Left leg straight up. You're going to lean forward. Give me one push up. Then from here, you're going to tap the right toe. Lift your body up to three legs, downward dog. Slowly again, right knee bend and right knee down. Then we start, we're going to do this for four rounds. Inhale, push up. Then push yourself up, exhale. That's right, relax, downward dog. Give me two more. Inhale and exhale. And down to the floor. So from here, you're gonna circle the hip out. Gonna be five out and five in. One, two, yes. Three, four, and five. Then reverse. Five, four, three, two, and one. Then from here, tap the right toe, right? You come up to three legs, downward dog. Circle the left hip out for five, circle in for five. One, two, three, four, and five. Reverse, five, four, three, two, and one. And lower the right knee down. Good job. So from here, circle your body, shift away from the left hand to the right hand, and you sit back. Inhale. Exhale. Another two rounds. And reverse. Shift away from the right palm to the left palm. Then sit back to child pose. Five. Four. Three. Two. One more time. Inhale and exhale. Then this time, keep your right leg back. Right leg up. Then again, we lean forward. One push up. Inhale. Tap the left toe. Exhale. Three legs. Downward dog. That's right. Continue another three rounds. Three, two, one more time, and one. Then lower the left knee down softly to the floor. Circle the right hip out for five, yes, four, three, two, and reverse, five, four, three, two, and one. Are you ready to go for the three legs? Downward dog. And again, circle the right hip out for five, four, three, two, and one. Reverse. Five, four, three, two, and one. And lower your knees down. So from here, my love, turn your palms up. The finger turn toward each other. And you sway your body side to side. Use only 5 to 10% of your effort just to feel the stretch at the back of your wrist joint. And you might give yourself a mini circle here, from right to the left. Still feel the gentle stretch at the back of your both wrist joint. And reverse, small circle here. Inhale, exhale. Slowly. And back to all four. Take a deep breath. Tap the toes. That's right. And come up to downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the right leg up. Exhale, keep the right foot placed between the head. And from here, let go the weight of your left leg down. And as you show, right, your right knee bend and be aligned with your right ankle joint. And you try to sink the weight of your left leg down to the floor. Feel the stretch at the front of your left leg. You're gonna give me one big circle here. Inhale. And then when you exhale, squeezing at your shoulder blades, circle your arms back and down. That's right. Now tap the left toe.
I'm not balancing what?
Yeah, that's happened. It's just like when we try to do the big circle, we're like, oh, I lose some balance. That's happened. This is gonna lose some balance more. So make sure you do it slowly, okay? Come up to the high lunge. Your front knee be aligned with your ankle joint. Do your best to keep your back leg straight. And one big circle here. Inhale. And exhale. Then you keep your palms down. Step right back because we're going to do the same on the left side. Left leg up, inhale, exhale, place left foot between hands. Then keep the right knee down, relax the right leg. Left knee, once again, be aligned with the right ankle joint. And one big circle here. Do it slowly. Tap the right toe, keep the right knee off the floor, high lunge. Front knee bend 90 degrees, keep your back leg straight. Inhale. And exhale. Then you keep your palms down, step left foot back. Walking up, bend the right knee. And switch with the left. After a few times of walking dog, stay still in downward facing dog. Keep your stomach in, keep your arms, keep your legs strong. Inhale your nose, sigh it out to your mouth. One more deep breath, inhale. And now, lift the right leg up. Inhale. Exhale, you still remember the wise thing. You're gonna turn the left toe to the right side. Keep the right toe at the left side of the mat. Right hand up, inhale here. And you lower the hip down. Exhale, inhale, be ready, and exhale, lift the hip up, then back to the center, three legs, downward dog, and now place the right foot between your hands, high lunge, inhale, you bring your arms up, then slowly from here, rest your left foot, and reverse warrior. Inhale and exhale. Your right hand next to your right foot. Open the chest and keep your left hand up, look up. 3, 2, and 1. Then from here, keep your palms down, step your right leg back. Back to downward dog. This time we're gonna do the one thing on the left side. Left leg up, inhale and exhale. Keep the left toe at the right side of the mat. Then you lower your hip down, inhale. Yes, and exhale, lift the hip up, left hand up. Open the chest. And now, left hand back to the mat. Back to three legs, downward dog, left leg up, inhale. Exhale, left foot between hands. Come up to high lunge, inhale here. Exhale. Warrior two. Reverse warrior. And the side ankle pose. So engage your core, raise your right hand up, stay 3, 2, 1. Keep your palms down, step your left back, take a deep breath. Stay still in downward dog for 3 deep breaths. Engaging your core. Now inhale, lift the right leg up. Exhale here, still remember that we need one thing. You're gonna turn to the left side first. Keep your right leg straight. Left hand up, open the chest, look up. Inhale now and exhale, keep your left hand back. And from here, I want you to lower your body all the way down as you want to kiss the mat. Come up slowly. Get ready, lift the hip up. And kick your right leg back. Three legs, downward dog. And now place the right foot between hands. So from high lunge, swing your arms back, close your body, and lift your left foot back. The airplane pose. Engaging your core, look down to the floor. 3, 2, 1. Then keep your palms down. Extend your left back, right back, downward dog. Stay in downward dog for 3 deep breaths. I assume that you are ready, so left leg up, inhale and exhale. We need one thing. Turn the toes to the right side, keep your left leg straight, right hand off. Then slowly keep your right hand down. Lower the hip down, elbows bend. Inhale, exhale. Then back to three legs, double dog. Left foot placed between the hands, high lunge, inhale. Swing your arms back. Close your body and exhale. Airplane pose, engaging your core, look to the floor. 3, 2, 1. Slowly keep the right foot back. Palms down, step left back. So paddling your legs side by side, walking out of your tongue. And yet, stay still in downward dog for the next 3 deep breaths. left leg up this time. Inhale. Exhale, place the left foot between hands. And slowly come up to high lunge. Slowly from here, my love, you join your hands together. You keep your arms close to the ear. And do your best to lengthen your spine, looking straight. Feel, hey, that I keep my right leg straight. I keep my left knee bent and be aligned with my left ankle joint. From here, keep your right hand behind the back. And if possible, grab your left inner thigh. Left arm straight up and close to the left ear. And stay for 3, 2, 1. And slowly, left hand down, right hand up, side angle pose. So this is the option one. Or the option two, interlace your finger behind your back, shoulder away from the ears, arm away from the back. And give me the hammer warrior. You're going to try to lower your forehead close to your front foot. But you're going to look to the back foot. Stay for 3, 2, and 1. Then from here, keep your palms down, step left back. Inhale, lean forward to the plank, shoulder over your hand, knees down, rest the toe. Exhale, chin, chest down. Then inhale. Upward dog, shoulder away from the ears. Lift your body up as much as you can. Engage your buttock, your inner thigh. Exhale, downward facing dog. Stay in downward dog for 3 deep breaths. And now lift the right leg up, inhale, exhale, right foot placed between hands, high lunge. So front knee be aligned with the ankle joint, left leg straight, arms up. Keep your arms close to the ear, lengthen the spine, reaching your arms up towards ceiling. Then from here, you keep your left foot flat. And instead of warrior two or reverse warrior, left hand behind the back, right? And now you try to grab your front thigh, perfect. Right arm up over the head, arm close to the ear, stay for 3, 2, 1. Then back to the center. And option one, either you try to go with the angler pose, or I think you already know the option two, the humble warrior. Interlock your finger behind your back, and yet, lower your body down close to the front foot. But you're gonna look to the back foot. Stay for 3, 2, 1. Gently keep your palms down, step right back, downward dog. Inhale, plank. Again, you hold a plank, shoulder over your hands, knees, toe relax, chin, chest down, the Ashtanga pose. Inhale, upward dog. Come up. Activate your butt cheek, your inner thigh. Slowly from here. Again, you can do this half circle at your neck. Right ear close to the right shoulder, chin to chest. The left ear close to the left shoulder.
I feel tightness in my lower back.
So if you feel tight at your lower back, make sure you need to squeeze in more at your butt cheeks, at your inner thigh, or else simply sit back to Shy Pose, not to Shy Pose, sorry, to the Hero Pose. And continue with the next circle. Sometimes sitting for the long period of time on the chair, working in front of the computer, we put a lot of tension to our lower back. Sometimes we carry your baby, and each and every day, baby is getting heavier and heavier. With our poor technique, it may hurt our back as well. And also that during the pregnancy, right, a lot of hormone, it just make our position, the body is shifting and change in some position, change in some manner, so lower back pain is happening. So it's good that to work at the lower back as well as to good to work at the core muscle as well. Alright, so from here, you're gonna lie by the side and face to our stomach.
Can I drink water?
Definitely. So after you sip the water, you come and you just relax. Let me relax. It is a sexy side line. Oh yeah. So let's start from engaging the core. So now you're gonna side lie on your left side, yeah? Relax the belly, so you should feel that there is no space between the waistline and the floor. Upper body totally relaxed, lower body is the same. Inhale, you relax, exhale, wrap the belly in. Inhale, relax. Exhale. The moment you wrap the belly in, so you're gonna feel that there is the space between the waistline and the floor. So inhale down, exhale, inhale, and exhale. Now from here, two direction, right? Once you exhale, wrap the belly in, feel there is the space. At the same time, when you exhale, you're going to push your right palm down to the floor, okay? Inhale, you relax the palm, you relax the belly. Exhale, belly up and pressing your palm down to the floor. So inhale, relax, and exhale, five. Four, three, two, one more time. Inhale, exhale, wrap the belly in and up and press the right palm down towards the ground and relax. Then from here, come up to the side plank modify. Shoulder over the elbow. Yeah. Either you keep your right hand helping you on the floor or right hand by the hip. Inhale, you be ready. Exhale, wrap the belly in and lift the hip up. So you should see first your left shoulder over the left elbow. But if the exercise becomes challenging for you, allow the right hand to help you for support, yeah? Inhale, hip down. Exhale, wrap the belly in and lift the hip up. So inhale down. Exhale. One more deep breath. Left, wrapping the belly in and exhale. Now from here, While you're still engaging the core, the hip up high. Exhale, open the right knee up.
My shoulder.
That's happened. That's why we have the other hand helping us. The posture is there. The core is working. Now come to the lower part. 3, 2, and 1. And relax. And let's work on the other side. Sit. Lie on the right side, relax your upper body, stack the knee on the top of each other. So first 5 times, we work only on the core, engaging. Inhale, you relax. Exhale, wrap the belly in and out, feel the space between waistline and the floor. Inhale, relax, and exhale. Very good. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now, second technique. While we exhale, we're gonna press the left palm down towards the floor as well, right? Just forget this part. Closer to the chest is easier. Closer to the belly is a little bit harder. Inhale, you relax. And exhale, left palm facing down, wrap the belly in and out, inhale, relax, and exhale, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then from here, come to the modified side plank. Right shoulder over the right elbow. Inhale, you relax. Then whenever you exhale, wrap the belly in and lift the hip up. Good, good. So, inhale, exhale. 4, 3, 2, one more time, and 1. While you wrap your belly in, if you feel so much on your shoulder, keep the left hand helping you. Inhale and exhale, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then from here, stay in all four. So if you still remember of the bird dog position, you're gonna work on engaging the core, right? So make sure that you're not really going to drop the belly down or you're not really going to round the spine. Let you find your neutral position. Not too relaxed and not too contract. So find your neutral position. Gently engaging your core. Right leg back, left hand forward. Then keep it down. And left leg back, right arm forward, then bring it back. So this exercise as a bird dog should not be easy because I don't want to see like this. So I really want you to control, keep your hip stay steady. Which means we're gonna try to do as slow as possible. Yes. Very good. So give me another 6 times. Inhale. Six. four. Three, two, and one. Good job. Tuck the toes, take a deep breath, exhale, downward dog. Inhale, you lift your right leg up. Exhale, place the right foot between the hands and lower your body down. Good job. So from here, keep your hands on your right knee. Perfect. Inhale, you'll be ready. Exhale, you're gonna push your body away. Maybe you should feel the stretch at the front of your left leg. Stay for three deep breaths. Good, good. Nice. And release slowly here. Keep the tip of your hands down. Inhale, you'll be ready. Exhale. Keep your right leg as straight as you can. Point the right toe up. Feel the stretch at your right hamstring. Shake, do your best to keep your back straight, engaging your core. And now you turn to me. So you keep your right leg straight, right? Right hand up here, inhale and exhale. So right knee bend, right elbow bend, and working at the waistline. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Take a deep breath. Slowly from here, grab your right toe with your right hand. Lift it up, kick it back. Stay for three deep breaths. Release slowly, and from here, left knee off the floor, step right back, so back to downward dog, and now left turn, inhale, left up, exhale, place the left foot between the hands, and you keep the right knee down, yep. And from here, relax your hands on your left knee. Are you ready? Inhale first and exhale. So push your arms away from the left knee. Stay for three deep breaths. And release slowly. Hands close to your left foot. Inhale. And exhale, left leg straight. Do your best to keep your whole back flat. Engaging the core. Feel the stretch at the back of your left leg. And now you turn to the right side. But again, I want you to face to me. So when you face to me, you're gonna keep your left leg straight, right knee bent.
Okay, wait. Me and my coordination, I need to think.
No problem. So keep your left leg straight, right knee bent. Yes. Inhale. So your left arm up over the head. And exhale. Left knee, left elbow bend. That's right. So work on the oblique. Two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So keep your left knee bent, then grab your left toe, kick it up and back. Open the chest, stay for 3, 2,